What I mean by the word awakened consciousness, see, if you are not at all introduced to the consciousness, the existence of consciousness, you will never enjoy the life to its fullest. You will just live with these four forces and leave the body. When you are introduced to this fifth and most important power, see, consciousness itself is a power. When it is embodied and manifest through your body, it is a force. I should say fifth force of the nature is awakened consciousness working through the body. Embodied, awakened consciousness. Jivan Mukta. I can say Jivan Mukta. Understand? Shiva, Parama Shiva, when he manifests with a form, is Parameshwara. Then, he can play with all the four forces. Now I want you to understand. Getting introduced about consciousness in your system, in your cognition, a new possibility opens. This is the logic or the science of the fifth power. Listen. Today I will reveal all the important truths about the science of the fifth power. One. The space katakasha. Listen, I'm using the word katakasha and showing this. It means even the place where we are living, I call it as kata. Mahakasha is the open space. I'll give you this example. Listen to this example. The open space, Mahakasha, and the space inside the pot, Katakasha, because of the Jati Akasha, both are one and the same. Listen carefully. The space, open space, and the space inside the pot. Inside the space inside the pot is called Katakasha. The open space is called Mahakasha. Mahakasha and Katakasha, because of their jati, they are one and the same. Because of their upadhi, they are different. Jati means by its nature they are one and the same. Upadhi means by their, because of their attributes they are different. If you just meditate on this one powerful cognition, your consciousness can be awakened. Listen, same way how Mahakasha, Mahakasha means pure space, Katakasha, the space inside the pot. These two, because of their jati, they are one and the same. but because of their upadhi attributes, they are different. Same way, Paramashiva and the soul operating in your body. Paramashiva and the soul operating in your body, both are by their jati of consciousness one and the same. By their nature of the consciousness, they are one and the same. By their upadhi attributes, they may look different. Understand? You feeling you are different from Paramashiva is disrespect to Paramashiva. You feeling you are one with Paramashiva is the respect to Paramashiva. Many time people claim, oh, if we say we are God, are we not disrespecting God? You are wrong. Only politician will feel threatened if you say you are him, you are same or you are equal, you are one with him. God does not understand. The nature of God is consciousness. By jati, you are one with Paramashiva. Only by upadhi, the attribute, there is difference. Understand? If you understand this powerful truth, this can help you to play with gravity, electromagnetism, the weak nuclear force and the strong force, all four. This can help you to strategize and win in all situations of life.